Sabbath, everyone.
Sabbath.
How many of you guys are happy at Sabbath?
Right.
All right, that's a pretty good majority. I guess all the tired people are going to basketball. Well, now I'm going to invite you guys to come and sing with us. We are going to start off with Blessed Be Your Name.
Your name.
Alright, so now it's the part of the song service where I'm gonna have to ask you to stand. We're doing this not for ourselves, not for the staff members here, but we're doing this to stand in the glory and the respect of our Lord. Because we're not here for anybody else, we're here for Him. We are here to worship Him. Sabbath. Please be with the speaker tonight and help his words to be able to bless every single person in this room. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Well, good evening, everyone. Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
I'm delightful to introduce the speaker tonight. As many of you know, I pray and pray and pray and have faith, and God answered my prayer. Do you know what my prayer was? Get a husband. So I did. He sent me one, wonderful husband, and I'm proud and delightful to introduce my husband, Mr. Villarroel, and Dean Eddie, who's going to translate tonight. So give him a warm welcome.
Buenas noches, muchachos.
Good evening, everyone.
Creo que no había recibido tanto aplauso desde mi graduación de dentista.
I don't think I've received this much applause since my graduation from dental school.
Primero, para los que no me conocen, soy de Chile.
For those of you who don't know me, first of all, I'm from Chile.
Por eso traje estas imágenes que no se ven aquí.
That's why I brought these images that you can't see here, but you can see over there.
Okay. Si no sabían, Chile está al fin de Sudamérica.
You didn't know Chile is in the south of South America.
Y tiene montañas muy altas, como los Andes, que se llaman los Andes.
It has a lot of tall mountains, the Andes.
Tiene la isla de Pascua.
Has the island of Pascua.
¿Dónde están las estatuas?
Where the statues are.
Okay. Esas solamente son las cabezas. Empezaron a desenterrarlas y hay como tres veces más grande el cuerpo hacia abajo.
So that's only the heads you see there, but there's about three more of those size of the rest of the body under the ground.
También tenemos, bueno, si ven nuestra costa en la costa del Pacífico, en el mapa, tenemos muchas playas.
Well, if you notice there in the, we're in the east coast of the map of the Pacific, we have a lot of beaches.
Tenemos playas con aguas muy transparentes y otras no tanto.
We have a lot of beaches with very clear water and some with not clear water.
Como todo país tiene que tener sus cascadas.
Like any other country have our waterfall.
Pero yo creo que solamente pocos países tienen los grandes glaciales que son como edificios, grandes torres que caen todos los días al agua.
But very few countries probably could have glaciers like we have that are as tall as buildings.
Bueno, aquí esto es parte de mi casa en Chile.
This is part of my home in Chile.
Esta es la Universidad Adventista en Chile.
This is the Adventist University in Chile.
Mi familia vive ahí.
My family lives there.
El primer edificio que ven allá, a mi derecha.
The first building you see here at the left.
Es el edificio de teología.
That's the theology building.
Al centro tenemos el templo.
In the middle we have the church.
Donde están estos jardines, aquí está lo que es la cafetería.
On the right is our cafeteria where the, you see the garden.
El otro edificio azul que ven allá es nuestra biblioteca.
This building here to the bottom left is our library.
Y como toda universidad tiene su patio de banderas.
And like a lot of universities we have our own circle of flags.
Así que cualquiera que quiera después estudiar en la universidad, hacer intercambio y aprender un poco de español.
So those of you who are interested about being an exchange student and learn some Spanish,
es bienvenido para ir a Chile y puede ser recibido en mi casa.
You're welcome to come to Chile and welcome to my home.
Okay, pero yo no vine a hablar de mí hoy en día.
I didn't come to talk about myself today.
Claro, porque es el día del Señor.
Of course not, because it's the Lord's Day.
Uh-huh. Y tengo una preocupación.
I have a concern.
Quiero saber si ustedes creen que nuestra iglesia es la iglesia verdadera.
I want to know if you believe our church is the real church.
A ver, pueden levantar sus manos.
Anybody raise your hand?
Uh-huh. Okay. ¿Por qué digo esto?
Why do I ask this?
Hace unos años atrás, cuando salí de la universidad.
Many years ago when I left the university.
Muchos de mis amigos ya no están adventistas, ya no están en la iglesia.
Many of my friends are no longer associated with the church.
Se han ido a otras iglesias.
They've gone to other churches.
Y estas iglesias son estas famosas iglesias masivas.
They've gone to a lot of famous mega churches.
Que aceptan a personas de todas religiones.
They accept people from all religions.
Y se fueron porque decían que nuestra iglesia, que nuestra iglesia verdadera, la iglesia adventista, pienso yo.
And they left because they were saying about our true church that I believe is the true church.
Dicen que nuestra iglesia es aburrida.
They would say our church is boring.
Tradicional.
Traditional.
Que no alaban a Dios como debería ser.
That we don't worship God the way we should worship God.
Entonces, yo pienso, bueno, yo estoy en la iglesia porque pienso, uso la razón.
I'm in the church because I have a reason that I'm in the church.
Así yo estoy en la iglesia porque creo en la Biblia.
I believe in this church because I believe in the Bible.
Uh-huh. Y no me dejo llevar por las pasiones de cantos y cantos y cantos y no hay ningún tipo de predicación.
And I'm not swayed by just the emotion or feelings of praise and praise song. I believe in beliefs.
Okay, vamos a revisar la presentación que hice, que la tomé de consejos y de predicaciones de otros pastores, porque yo soy dentista, no soy teólogo.
We're going to go over this presentation I put together, and it's come from different sources, from other people I've counseled with, and other messages I've heard, because I'm not a preacher, I'm just an Adventist.
Okay. Muchas personas preguntan, ¿Dios tiene una iglesia verdadera?
Many people ask themselves, does God have a true church?
¿Cómo puede haber solamente una iglesia de Dios?
How can there be just one church of God?
Existiendo muchas iglesias en el mundo.
When there are so many churches in the world today.
¿Cuántos saben cuántas iglesias protestantes hay en Estados Unidos?
How many of you guys know how many Protestant churches are in the U.S.?
¿Cuántos serán?
Anybody?
1,000 or 30,000?
1,000, 1,300?
Muchas.
Many.
Parece correcto decir que debe existir solamente una iglesia verdadera habiendo tantas iglesias.
Do you think it's politically correct or appropriate to say that there's only one true church when there are so many churches out there?
¿No será un pensamiento muy radical, muy cerrado de mente?
Maybe it's a closed-minded thought or a radical thought.
Si realmente hay una iglesia de Dios, pues ¿dónde está?
If there is really only one church of God, where is it?
Veamos lo que dice Apocalipsis capítulo 12:1, está en la Biblia. Pueden leerlo en inglés.
Let's see what the Bible has to say in the book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 1. Does anybody have a Bible?
Pueden buscar
chapter
en su Biblia.
Revelation, chapter 12, verse 1.
Okay, aquí dice que hay una mujer.
Here it says there's a woman.
Y como ustedes saben, Apocalipsis es un libro simbólico.
And then, you know, the book of Revelation is a symbolic book.
Yeah, y esta mujer está representando a una iglesia.
And this woman is representing a church.
Okay, tenemos una mujer que tiene una corona.
We have a woman who has a crown.
Que tiene dos estrellas, doce estrellas.
That has 12 stars.
¿Y estas estrellas, alguien de ustedes sabe lo que representan?
Do you know what these stars represent?
12
tribus.
Las tribus, yo creo que son los apóstoles.
I think it represents the disciples.
Que Dios apoyó en los apóstoles para seguir el trabajo de su iglesia.
That God appointed to be able to further along his work.
Y ve que esta mujer está parada sobre la tierra.
You see that this woman is standing over the earth.
¿En la tierra?
Is it the earth?
¿Está parada sobre la tierra, muchachos?
Is she on the earth?
No. No.
No.
Esta mujer está parada sobre la luna.
She is standing on the moon.
Porque la luna refleja algo. ¿Qué refleja la luna?
Because the moon reflects what?
El sol.
The sun, yeah.
Entonces, ¿la iglesia qué refleja?
So what does the church reflect?
A Dios.
God.
¿No es cierto?
Reflects God.
Por eso, es un símbolo que tenemos que entender.
Because this is a symbol we have to understand.
Para saber que hay una iglesia verdadera.
To be able to understand that there's a one true church.
Pero simbólicamente también aparece una mujer vestida de rojo.
Symbolically, we also have a woman who's represented in red.
Pero esa mujer representa la iglesia o las iglesias que no pertenecen a Dios.
And she represents churches or the church or churches that don't belong, they aren't the true church.
Next. Leamos el verso 2.
12:2.
Sí,
12. And it says, chapter 12, verse 2, and she, being with child, cried, travailing in birth, and pained to be delivered.
Y esta iglesia o esta mujer estaba con labores de parto, ¿no es cierto?
And she was having a birthing pain.
¿Y quién iban a hacer de esta mujer?
What were they
iglesia?
What were they going to do with her or this church?
¿Quién iba a hacer?
What were they going to do?
Pregunta.
It's a question.
¿Quién nace de esta mujer? ¿Quién nace de esta mujer de esta iglesia?
What comes out of this woman, out of this birth?
Jesús, hijos.
Jesus. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns upon his head.
Y tan, pero entonces también sabemos que existe que Satanás, ¿no? El versículo está diciendo que existe Satanás.
We also know that in this verse they're describing or explaining that who exists, Satan.
Pasemos a la
next slide.
Okay, se llevó, Satanás se llevó consigo un tercio de los ángeles.
Satan took with him a third of the angels from heaven.
Ajá. La iglesia verdadera sabe eso.
The true church knows that.
Nació Jesús.
Jesus was born.
Y con la esperanza de la salvación para esta humanidad.
And with the hope of salvation and hope for humankind.
Pasemos a la siguiente.
The next one.
Entonces, este Satanás, este dragón, planeó desde un principio, dice la Biblia.
It says that this dragon or the devil planned since the beginning
eliminar a Jesús.
To eliminate Jesus.
Entonces, Satanás se metió en la mente, en el corazón de Herodes.
And Satan influenced Herod's mind and heart.
Y Herodes mandó a eliminar a todos los niños que presuntamente tenían como la edad de Jesús en esa época.
So he decreed to kill all the babe, male boys about the age of Jesus and condemned them to death.
Esto es terrible. Imagínense cómo representa esa imagen.
This is terrible if you can just imagine just from that image what it represents.
Imagínense que vengan y te quiten a tu hijo amado y lo asesinen.
Can you imagine that they would take your baby boy and kill him?
Dios antes les reveló a José que tenían que irse y se fueron a Egipto.
So God revealed to Joseph that they needed to leave and flee to Egypt.
Por eso Jesús se pudo salvar.
That's why Jesus was able to be saved.
Next. Leamos lo que dice el verso 5 de Apocalipsis 14.
Okay, verse 5. And she brought forth a man child who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up unto God and to his throne.
Y la iglesia verdadera también cree que después Jesús retornó de nuevo al cielo.
The true church believes that Jesus went back up to heaven.
Para estar con el Padre.
To be with the Father.
Y a cumplir una misión específica.
To complete a specific mission.
Que van a tener de tarea.
That we are going to have as homework.
Okay, see you next. Bueno, ¿cómo sabemos? Dice, pues usted está leyendo solamente el último libro de la Biblia.
We're only reading the last book of the Bible.
Bueno, hay otras citas que dicen que Jesús realmente iba a venir a este mundo.
But there are other verses that say that Jesus was is going to come back to this earth.
Tenemos Isaías 66:7 y Salmos 2:9.
We have Isaiah 66:7 and Psalms 2:9.
Entonces Isaías 66:7 dice.
So Isaiah 66:7. Oh, before she goes into labor, she gives birth, before the pains come upon her, she delivers a son.
Okay. Esto confirma, la Biblia siempre se va confirmando entre ellas.
The Bible always confirms himself as you go through it.
Históricamente también.
Historically also.
La Biblia se explica solo, muchachos.
The Bible can explain itself.
Hay que estudiarla.
You gotta study it.
Sigamos.
Continue.
Entonces, el próximo verso explica.
So the next verse explains.
Que esta iglesia tuvo que, en una época, esconderse, huir.
That there's a certain time when this church had to hide or flee.
¿Puedes leer el verso?
And it says, verse 6, the woman fled into the wilderness to a place prepared for her by God, where she might be taken care of for 1,260 days.
Esta fue la época más oscura de nuestra iglesia.
This was the darkest time of our church.
En que donde, next, donde los hombres tuvieron que huir.
To where everyone needed to flee.
Los que leían la Biblia.
Those who would read the Bible had to
flee. Los que guardaban el sábado.
Those who would keep the Sabbath had to flee.
Todavía no existía la iglesia adventista.
The Adventist church didn't exist yet.
Porque La iglesia verdadera existe desde siempre.
Because the true church has always existed.
Y estas personas tuvieron que esconderse en Europa, en las altas montañas, en los lugares más refugiados.
These people had to flee into the highest mountain ranges in Europe.
Y esto sucedió desde 1538 a 1798.
And this happened between 538 to 1798.
La iglesia verdadera tiene que saber esto.
The true church needs to know this.
Es historia de nosotros.
It's our story.
Sigue. Entonces, características de nuestra iglesia.
So these are characteristics of the true church at the end times.
Que están en este verso 17.
That are in this verse. And it says, then the dragon was enraged at the woman and went off to wage war against the rest of her offspring, those who keep God's commands and hold fast their testimony about Jesus.
¿Alguien me puede decir las dos características que vio aquí en este verso?
Can someone tell me the two characteristics listed in this verse?
Es fácil.
It's easy.
Facilísimo.
It's very
easy. Mandamientos y guardar la fe de Jesús o el testimonio de Jesús.
Commandments and keep the testimony of Jesus.
Fácil.
Easy.
No hay cómo perderse.
There's no way to lose.
Next. Tenemos nuestros mandamientos.
We have our commandments.
Y solo tenemos fe en Jesús.
And we have faith in Jesus.
Son nuestro centro. Esto nunca debemos perder nuestro centro.
It's the core of our message. We should never lose the core of our message.
El centro que nos identifica.
Or the core that identifies us.
Los mandamientos.
The commandments.
Y creer en Jesús.
And believe in Jesus.
Las otras iglesias, la mayoría no creen en los mandamientos.
Many other churches don't believe in the commandments.
Le quitan parte de los mandamientos.
They take away parts of the.
Y solamente quieren cantar y alabar a Jesús.
They only want to sing and praise Jesus.
Pero sin reglas.
But without rules.
Pero no saben que estas reglas son de libertad.
But they don't understand these rules are for liberation, liberty.
Continuemos. Hay mucha gente sincera que frecuenta la iglesia y estudia la Biblia.
There's very many sincere people that go to church and study the Bible.
También hay iglesias que se atacan unas con otras.
There also are churches that attack one another.
¿Qué pasa? ¿No es la misma Biblia para toda la iglesia?
Don't we all study the same book, the same Bible?
¿No estudiamos el mismo mensaje?
Don't we study the same message?
¿Por qué la confrontación actualmente entre las iglesias? ¿Por qué algunas dicen que no, ellas son la iglesia verdadera y las otras no? ¿Por qué piensan?
So why do we have sometimes a confrontation between who's the actual church and who's not?
Pues yo pienso que es por nuestra humanidad.
I think it's because of our humanity.
Por nuestro pensamiento pecaminoso humano.
Because of our sinful human thinking.
Tenemos la iglesia no es como un equipo de fútbol.
The church isn't like a football team.
En que me pongo una camiseta y después me la saco y después el otro equipo ganador, me pongo la otra camiseta y después me la saco.
It's not like I can put on this jersey and I'll play for this team and then take it off and put on the other team's jersey and I'm part of this team now.
La iglesia es algo de salvación.
The church is about salvation.
Sí, algo que tú tienes que decidir para siempre o buscar lo correcto para salvarte.
It's because you want to be saved. You want to choose to do the thing to save you.
Y sucede algo.
Something happens.
No somos suficientemente humildes.
We're not necessarily humble.
Para obedecer lo que dice la Biblia.
To be able to obey what the Bible says.
¿Es difícil para cada persona por sí misma descubrir cuál es la iglesia verdadera?
Do you think it's difficult for each person for themselves to discover which is the true church?
Porque toda la iglesia dice que son verdaderas.
So why do all churches claim to be the true church?
No basta con decir, yo soy la iglesia verdadera.
It's not enough to say, we are the true church.
Para ser la iglesia verdadera hay que tener las características de la iglesia verdadera.
To be the true church, you need to have the characteristics of the true church.
Leamos Apocalipsis 14:6.
Let's read Revelation 14:6. Then I saw another angel flying in mid-air, and he had the eternal gospel to proclaim to those who live on the earth, to every nation, tribe, language, and people. He said in a loud voice, "Fear God and give him glory, because the hour of his judgment has come. Worship him who made the heavens, the earth, the sea, and the springs of water."
¿Ustedes conocen otra iglesia que predique sobre el juicio final, sobre el término final de este mundo?
Do you know of another church that speaks about the judgment at the end?
Ese ángel que representa a un mensajero somos nosotros. Estamos llevando el mensaje.
That angel that's representing a message, that's us.
Nosotros tenemos que llevar el mensaje.
We are to take this message.
El verso siete, por favor.
Okay. Revelation 14:7. He said in a loud voice, "Fear God and give him glory, because the hour of his judgment has come. Worship him who made the heavens and the earth, the sea and the springs of water."
Nadie predica que el juicio ha llegado.
There's very few that talk about the judgment hour.
Que esté fuera de nuestra iglesia.
That's really outside of our church.
Comparemos con Éxodo 20:11.
We need to compare this to Exodus 20:11. And verse 8.
Estos son los mandamientos.
These are the commandments. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work. But the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you, nor your son or daughter, nor your male or female servant, nor your animals, nor any foreigner residing in your towns. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea, and all that is in them, but he rested on the seventh day. Therefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy.
A mí esto me impresiona.
To me, this is impresses upon me.
Cómo la Biblia se va copiando y se va confirmando.
How the Bible copies itself and confirms itself.
Si ven esa parte en azul, si la leen de nuevo.
If you see that's highlighted in blue and read it again.
Retrocedemos.
Let's go back one.
También dice el verso 7 que adore el que hizo el cielo, la tierra, el mar y los manantiales, el que hizo todo.
Yeah, it says also, verse 7, worship him who made the heavens, the earth, the sea, and the springs of water.
Entonces esto confirma que el que vino a nacer por nosotros está en los mandamientos porque fue el creador de todo.
And this confirms that him who came to be born on this earth also created what's listed here, and he's the creator.
Está en los mandamientos y está en Apocalipsis.
He is in the very commandments in Exodus and in Revelation.
¿Y cuándo llegó la hora del juicio? Todos sabemos.
When did the judgment
¿Cuándo
time
comenzó
come?
La hora del juicio?
We all know this.
Esto fue el 22 de octubre de 1844.
It was October 22nd, 1844.
Y nuestra iglesia es la única iglesia que habla y predica sobre el santuario.
We really are the only church that talks and speaks about the sanctuary.
Y habla sobre la misión que está haciendo Jesús en el lugar santísimo.
And we're really the only ones that talk about the work that Jesus is doing now in the holy place. In the most holy place.
Yo sé que están cansados, pero quiero que veamos realmente que nuestra iglesia verdadera.
I know you're a little tired, but I want you to stick with me because I want to show you
porque,
that we are the real church.
Porque no quiero a ninguno de ustedes verlos afuera adorando a otra iglesia que no tiene fundamentos.
Because I wouldn't like you to see you leave our church to worship another place that doesn't have any foundation or true foundation. Go back one.
Pero
no. One more.
Si yo no quiero acercarme a esa iglesia que tiene esas características, ¿coloco en riesgo mi salvación? ¿Será que yo no puedo ir al cielo?
If I don't want to associate myself with the church with these characteristics, am I putting my salvation at risk? Would it be possible that I wouldn't be able to go to heaven?
Muchachos, esto no es obligatorio. Lo más lindo, lo más sagrado que Dios nos dio, nos regaló, fue la libertad.
This is not, this isn't forced. The most beautiful thing God has given us is freedom.
Dice Apocalipsis 30:20.
Revelation 3:20 says, "Here I am. I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with that person, and they with me."
Jesús no entra a la casa, no entra a tu corazón rompiendo la puerta a fuerzas.
Jesus doesn't come into your home or to your heart by breaking the door down.
Tú abres tu corazón de adentro para aceptarlo.
You open your heart to let him in to accept him.
Tú decides.
You decide.
Es tu libertad.
It's your freedom. It's your choice.
Hebreos 10:26.
Hebrews 10:26. If we deliberately keep on sinning after we have received the knowledge of the truth, no sacrifice for sins is left.
Jóvenes.
Young people.
Este versículo es para temer.
This is a verse to fear.
Si puedes recibir el conocimiento de la verdad, pecamos obstinadamente y ya no hay sacrificio por los pecados.
If we deliberately keep on sinning after we have received the knowledge of the truth, no sacrifice for sin is left.
Si tú eres testarudo,
if you're hard-headed,
si eres cerrado de mente,
if you're closed-minded,
ya no va a haber salvación.
There won't be salvation.
Una vez que sabes la verdad,
once you know the truth,
¿la escoges o no?
You either just choose it, yes or no.
Sí. Aquellas personas que no han estudiado o no han comprendido, no han escuchado nunca de estas cosas, o estas características, pero buscan con sinceridad a la iglesia verdadera.
There are people who have never studied or have understood or haven't heard these characteristics, but search with sincerity this church.
¿Qué pasa con esto?
What happens with this?
Hay una imagen de una mujer con la cara sucia, ¿no?
There's an image there of a lady with a dirty face.
Pensemos que esta mujer es bien feliz, es muy sincera.
Let's say this lady is a happy lady, a very sincere lady.
Ella quiere hacer el bien.
She wants to do good.
Está buscando la verdad.
She's searching for truth.
Y esta mujer, que es alegre y sincera, está con la cara sucia y va caminando por el mundo y la gente la mira así con reojo.
And let's say this lady who's so sincere and searching, with a dirty face, is walking around, people look at her kind of weird.
Y ella, bueno, no sabe por qué la miran así de reojo.
But she doesn't know why they're looking at her like that.
Pero viene alguien y toma un espejo y se lo muestra.
But somebody comes along, has a mirror and shows it to her.
Y la Biblia es como un espejo.
The Bible is a mirror.
Entonces ella se ve el espejo y se da cuenta que está sucia.
She looks at the mirror and notices that her face is dirty.
En ese momento se te acabó la sinceridad.
Well, at that point, ignorance is gone.
Y si no quieres lavarte la cara,
if you don't want to wash your face,
es porque eres testarudo.
It's because you're choosing for not.
Es porque eres duro de cabeza.
It's because you're hard-headed.
Sigamos. ¿Qué pasa con estas personas que saben de estas características, que están en otras iglesias, pero no quieren guardar estas características?
What happens with these people who know about these characteristics but don't want to do anything about them?
Y dicen que es por la... No, es que por tradición yo no puedo dejar mi familia.
It's because of tradition. I can't leave because of my family.
Mi grupo de amigos.
My group of friends.
Veamos lo que dice la Biblia con este tipo de pregunta o de explicación de por qué no.
Let's see what the Bible says to these responses to this.
Leamos Mateo 10:37.
Matthew 10:37. Anyone who loves their father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. Anyone who loves their son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me.
Siguiente. Next. continuación de la diapositiva anterior. En el mundo están, hay dos cosas. Se presentan los corderitos y los cabritos.
There are the sheep and there are the goats.
La mujer con vestido blanco y la mujer con vestido rojo.
The lady with the white dress and the lady with the red dress.
Las vírgenes prudentes y las insensatas.
The wise virgins and the not so wise virgins.
Solamente hay dos.
There's only two parts.
Lo más difícil en esta vida es tomar una decisión.
One of the most difficult things in life is to make a decision.
Cuando Abraham tenía 66 años,
when Abraham had 66, was 66 years old,
Dios le pidió que dejara todo.
God asked him to leave everything.
Su hogar, sus amigos, su familia.
His friends, his family.
Un hombre de 66 años que deje todo.
A man of 66 years old to leave everything.
A lo mejor ustedes que son jóvenes es más fácil que tomar para ustedes una decisión.
Maybe it's easier because you're young to make a decision.
Espero que tomen la decisión correcta.
I hope you make the right decision.
Sigamos. Y algunos dirán, pero Dr. Nelson, esto es muy radical, es un pensamiento muy estrecho de mente.
Well, some people would say, Dr. Nelson, this position is radical, it's too extreme.
¿Cómo va a ser que exista solamente una iglesia verdadera?
How can there only exist one true church?
Pero como le explicaba antes, solamente existe una postura para Dios.
And as I was explaining before, there's only one position, one choice for God.
¿Eres de él o no eres de él?
You're of his or you're not of his.
Muchachos, llegará el día en que se volarán de ustedes y verán que están locos.
It's going to come a day where they're going to be making fun of you, calling you crazy.
Pero no tengan miedo.
But don't fear.
El que comenzó la obra en ti, ciertamente la terminará.
He who has begun a good work will finish it.
Jesús siempre te va a acompañar por este largo camino.
Jesus is always going to be with you on this long road.
Aunque tengas que derramar lágrimas,
even if you shed tears,
y acostado en tu cama tengas que llorar en silencio,
and you might be laying in your bed and you need to cry in silence,
Dios sabe por qué te llamó.
God knows why he called you.
Y Dios sabe dónde quiere llevarte.
And God knows where he wants to take you.
Que Dios los bendiga y que tengan un feliz sábado.
And God may bless you and have a happy Sabbath.
Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for your word and for the truth. Thank you because we have the privilege to know this truth, and I know with that comes responsibility, but you also promise to be with us as we go through this. Help us to be faithful, help us to grow in you. Thank you for this freedom we have to choose you today. Help us to do so and help us to have a happy Sabbath. In your name I pray. Amen. Happy Sabbath. Miss Burger Town.